Morning.
Good morning. We want to welcome everyone, each and every one of you, and we hope you're ready for the blessing and the retreat that you're about to experience. So if you would, please stand and greet one another.
Okay, yeah, I'm going to ask if there's any more announcements. We have just a few announcements to make you aware of before we get started. And if you would please pick up the red friendship folder that's on the inside of the aisles and fill them out, please, and pass them on. Thank you. Due to the special services and holidays, we will not have Children's Sunday School or Children's Church through January 1st, and all classes will resume on January 8th. Our chancel choir will bless us with a Christmas cantata, The Greatest Story Ever Told, during the morning worship next Sunday, December 18th, and you won't want to miss that either. And everyone is invited to join us for an evening of dinner and Christmas praise and worship. Big Praise will host a dinner this Wednesday at 5 p.m., and please bring a dessert to share. Following the dinner, they will bring a time of Christmas worship at 6 o'clock. And please use the insert in today's bulletin to invite any friends and family that you would like to, and we encourage you to do that. Are there any other announcements? Macy?
Good morning. My name is Macy Newell, and my history teacher recently announced he's retiring at the end of the school year. He is wanting to take our class as his last annual trip to Washington, D.C. We are going to D.C. a year early, and this change has not given me much time to earn and fundraise money. I would appreciate working for you to help me raise money to go on this trip. If there's anything I can do for you, such as bake, babysit, shovel snow, clean, and organize, you can text or call me on the number 307-431-0047, and it's also listed in the bulletin. Thank you.
If there are no other announcements, let's go to the Lord. Dear Heavenly Father, we thank you for this beautiful day outside and invite you to this gathering of your people so we may lift up your name, Lord, and worship you. Please bless your message today that will be brought to us through the children of the church. Help all of us, Lord, to approach you as children, because that is when a person is most sincere and innocent and most willing to put their trust in you. We ask for your protection over the kids and their parents as they are growing up in a world that is waging a spiritual war against you, Lord. Thank you for their parents who are instilling your values into them, and help us all to be in the world but not of it. We ask, Lord, that you be with those who are hurting. We just send up a big praise and a thank you, Lord, for the fact that John Nielsen is here, and after having surgery, we ask that you continue to heal and strengthen him, Lord, along with Steve Marcus, Lord. Just be a calming presence in his life, Heavenly Father. Help him to feel your presence and continue to heal and strengthen him also, Lord. And be with Chuck and Sandy Mischke, Lord, along with their son. They need your healing touch also, Heavenly Father, and we ask for that. We ask that you please be with Pastor James and Jenna and Magdalene on their way back from Kansas. We hope and trust that their trip was an enjoyable one for them, and ask for your protection while they are driving. Please bless all parts of the service today, Lord. We pray that it will bring glory and honor to you and you alone. For you are worthy, you alone are worthy of the prayer that you taught your disciples when we say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen.
We are a people who seek to be brought together by love of Christ. Our faith teaches us that God gives us unconditional love and forgiveness. Acknowledge God's free gift of grace. We light the candle of love.
Let us pray. O Lord, prepare our hearts again to celebrate the coming of your Son and to receive in him your great love for us all. Amen.
Okay, we are down 6 people today, just this morning. So we have people doing other people's parts that they never even practiced before. You're going to see some switching of the animal hats because this is what we've got. So we're going to give it all we've got to the Lord, give praise to the Lord, and we're really excited to do this Manger Tales program for you.
We've all heard the stories of Mary, Joseph, the shepherds, and the wise men, but what about the others who were there when Jesus was born? Manger Tales will introduce you to the animals that were there, from the residents of the stable to the visitors from afar. As each animal pays a visit to a TV talk show, we will see the Christmas story through their eyes and get a fresh perspective on the wonder of Christmas.
Good morning. I'm Larry Prince. And today in my... Good morning. I'm Larry Prince. This is my brother Larry, my other brother Larry, and my other brother Larry. Today in Larry Prince Live, we're doing a 4-part series on the story of Christmas. We've all read the stories from the Gospels of Luke and Matthew, how the baby Jesus was born. But we've never heard the story from the people who were there. I tried to get a hold of those people to tell their stories, but none of them would talk to me. I think it's my bad breath. Anyway, I got to the next best thing. We're going to meet the animals from the Christmas story, starting with my guest today, Doug the Donkey. Doug, welcome to Larry Prince Live. It's Larry.
Thanks, Gary.
It's Larry.
It is?
Doug, do you remember meeting the baby Jesus?
Oh, what a little cutie. He was so cute. He was a cutie, Larry. He had the cutest little dimple.
You saw baby Jesus?
Saw him. I carried him all the way to Bethlehem.
I thought he was born in Bethlehem.
He was, but who do you think carried his mother, great with child, across the desert?
Was it you?
Well, it wasn't a jackrabbit.
I didn't think it was.
Can't imagine a jackrabbit carrying a pregnant lady.
Neither can I.
She'd say, "You mind if I hop on?" He'd say, "You mind if I hop on?" Aiming.
When did you know that this baby Jesus was someone special?
I knew Jesus was special before he was even born.
How?
Because of his mother and father. They talked about him on the way to Bethlehem. Couldn't stop talking about him. Now, mind you, most parents are like that, even if their kid is a goober.
Tell me about it.
But not all parents find out their baby from an angel. An angel went to Mary and said, "You're gonna have a baby." Then he went to Joseph and said, "All that stuff Mary told you about the baby is true."
That's quite a story.
Tell me about it. I was stopping for a drink of water. When I first heard it, I was so stunned, I did a spit take.
Really?
Water shot out of my nostrils. It was kind of embarrassing.
But did you really believe he was a gift from God when you heard about the angels?
Well, I was a little spectacle at first. Most times you hear guys talking about seeing angels. They turned out to be a little nuts, but then the baby was born, and these shepherds come, and then some wise guys.
You mean wise men?
I don't know how wise they were. They brought gold and spices to a newborn baby. You know, what a little baby needs diapers.
But you saw these things?
Yes, and when I saw them, I believed this was no regular baby. This was a special baby. And did he have a cute dimple?
Thanks for sharing your story, Doug. We'll be back after this word.
Did you ever sit and wonder why people watch cheesy talk shows? Why does mom love to sit and listen to people babble on and on about their kids, their career, and their next movie? And how in the world can dad sit and listen to those guys talk for hours and hours about sports? They do it for the same reason people read books. They watch talk shows for the same reason we watch movies. Everybody loves a good story. Christmas is a great time for stories. There's the one about Buddy the Elf, and the one about the kid with the BB gun. And then there's the one about a man, a woman, and an angel.
This is how the birth of Jesus, the Messiah, came about. His mother Mary was pledged to be married to Joseph, but before they came together, she was found to be pregnant through the Holy Spirit. Because Joseph, her husband, was faithful to the law, and yet did not want to expose her to public disgrace, he had in mind to divorce her quietly. But after he had considered this, an angel of the Lord appeared to him in a dream and said, "Joseph, son of David, do not be afraid to take Mary home as your wife, because what is conceived in her is from the Holy Spirit. She will give birth to a son, and you are to give him the name Jesus, because he will save his people from their sins." All this took place to fulfill what the Lord had said through the prophet. "The virgin will conceive and give birth to a son, and they will call him Emmanuel, which means God with us." When Joseph woke up, he did what the angel of the Lord had commanded him and took Mary home as his wife. But he did not consummate their marriage until she gave birth to a son. And he gave him the name Jesus.
Joseph and Mary were looking forward to their wedding. They thought they knew how their story was going. God put a twist into their tale and changed their lives for good. The twist that changed their tale changed our world, our whole world.
Welcome back to Larry Prince Live. My next guest is one of the animals who was there in the stable when Jesus was born. She was born and raised in Bethlehem, and she joins us now live. Please welcome Claire the cow.
Thank you for having me, Barry.
It's Larry.
It is?
Claire, I understand you live in the stable where the baby Jesus was born.
Oh, what a little angel face. He was so cute. He had the sweetest giggle and that dimple. Oh, that dimple was adorable.
You remember the baby Jesus being born?
I'll never forget it.
You must have been thrilled to see him.
Absolutely not.
What?
I was not at all thrilled with having a bunch of people in my house that night.
But it was.
All day long, Greg the goat kept saying, "The inn is filling up, they're running out of rooms." And I kept saying, "No way, they send people out here. Stables are for animals, not people." But what do you think happens around bedtime?
People in the stable.
A man, a donkey, and a pregnant woman who immediately goes into labor.
She went into labor right away?
As ready as she was, I'm surprised she made it to Bethlehem.
But she had a baby in the stable.
Oh, yes, and it's very difficult to sleep when someone is giving birth.
I guess so.
A cow has to have her sleep, Barry.
It's Larry.
And you can't sleep when someone's trying to birth a baby.
I see your point.
Oh, but when that baby was born, you just knew he was special.
You knew right away?
Well, the star and the shepherds kind of clued me in. But yes, the baby changed everything. The whole stable just felt different because of his presence.
I guess that made everything okay, huh?
Well, almost. I was still mad at the innkeeper.
What for?
Because you don't put a baby into a stable, especially if that baby is the son of God.
Good point.
So the innkeeper didn't get any milk for a few days.
Uh-oh.
Yes, and boy, were his customers mad when they didn't have milk for their frosted flakes.
Frosted flakes? Who's ever heard of frosted flakes in the ancient Bethlehem?
Well, who ever heard of a talking cow?
Good point. We've been talking with Claire the cow, resident of Bethlehem, about her memories about baby Jesus.
Oh, that dimple.
We'll be right back with another amazing animal Christmas story.
Imagine if Grandma came for Christmas and you made her sleep out in the shed. How would that go over in your house? Would you be happy seeing Grandma out with the lawnmower? I know Grandma wouldn't like it. When Jesus was born, there was no soft bed. There was only a borrowed food trough and a borrowed stable. It was dirty and noisy, and it was no place for a baby, let alone the Son of God. But even in that humble setting, it was clear that Jesus was no ordinary baby. In those days, Caesar Augustus issued a decree that a census should be taken of the entire Roman world. This was the first census that took place while Quirinus was governor of Syria, and Galilee to Judea, to Bethlehem, the town of David, because he belonged to the house and line of David. He went there to register with Mary, who was pledged to be married to him and was expecting a child. While they were there, the time came for the baby to be born, and she gave birth to her firstborn, a son. She wrapped him in clothes and placed him in a manger because there was no guest room available for them.
Imagine the creator of the universe, the Son of God who reigns in heaven, sleeping on a bed of hay. That's how Jesus entered the world, not as a conquering hero, but as the poor son of a carpenter. What an extraordinary beginning to a world-changing story.
Welcome back to Larry Prince Live. My next guest was not in the stable when Jesus was born, but he was there when God sent a special invitation to visit the newborn king. Please say hello to Sammy and Lammy the sheep.
Wee doggies, thanks for having me, Jerry.
It's Larry, Larry Prince. Don't you know me from TV?
Shucks no, Jerry, I'm a sheep. We don't got no TV out there in the pastures. You know, the ones beside the still waters.
Is that near the Valley of the Shadow of Death?
No, it's near Bethlehem.
That's right. You were in the field when the angels came to share the good news of Jesus with the shepherds.
Sure was.
What was it like seeing those angels appear in the sky?
Oh, Jerry, it was pretty. So pretty, them angels came out of nowhere with their halos and their wings and them instruments. What do you call them things?
Harps?
That's the deal. Anyways, they commenced to singing, "Glory to God in the highest, and peace on earth." It was the most glorious singing I ever heard.
And what did the shepherds do?
Oh, golly, Larry. They were so scared. They were just sore afraid.
Sore afraid?
That's right, sore afraid. One of them squawking in his boots. Another one's hiding his eyes. One of them thought the angels had come to take him to glory. He grabbed his harp and yelled, "I'm coming, Elizabeth."
Poor fellow.
Nah, but they was real happy when they calmed down and heard what you angel had to say. He was, "Oh, y'all should go see this thing, what has happened in Bethlehem." And they was, "Oh, yeah, we should go see this thing, what the angel sung about."
Did you get to go with them?
Of course I did. I had to see this thing for myself, Jerry.
Do you remember anything they said?
Well, he was tiny, and he was sleeping in the hay inside a manger. And he had the cutest little dimple afterwards. The shepherds headed back to the fields, praising God and telling all of us about the baby.
Amazing.
You know, Jerry, it always seemed kind of odd to me why the good Lord would invite a bunch of smelly shepherds to see his newborn son. But then I think God was just being neighborly. He sent Jesus for everybody, so he wanted to make sure everybody knew they was welcome, even smelly shepherds.
A beautiful message to end this interview.
And a smelly one. I mean it, Jerry. Them boys never bathe.
Thanks for joining us, Lammy. We'll see you next time on Larry Prince Live.
Me?
No, the kids.
Oh, I got it. Adios, buckaroo.
The people of Israel had waited for centuries for the birth of the Messiah. God told the story of his coming over and over through the prophets. But when the baby Jesus was born, he shared this story with a few lower shepherds.
And there were shepherds living out in the fields nearby, keeping watch over the flocks at night. An angel of the Lord appeared to them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were terrified. But the angel said to them, "Do not be afraid. I bring good news that will cause great joy for all the people. Today in the town of David, a Savior has been born to you. He is the Messiah, the Lord. This will be a sign to you. You will find the baby wrapped in cloths and lying in a manger." Suddenly, a great company of heavenly hosts appeared with the angel, praising God and saying, "Glory to the God in the highest heaven and peace on earth to those whom his favor rests." When the angels had left them and gone into heaven, the shepherds said to one another, "Let's go to Bethlehem and see this thing that has happened, which the Lord has told us about." So they hurried off and found Mary and Joseph and the baby who was lying in the manger. When they had seen him, they spread the word concerning what had been told to them about this child. Spread the word concerning what had been told to them about this child, and all who heard it were amazed at what the shepherds said to them. But Mary treasured up all these things and pondered them in her heart. The shepherds returned glorified and praising God for all the things that they had heard and seen, which were just as they had been told.
God told the shepherds that Jesus had been born, and when he did, he told the world that Jesus had come for all of us. Jesus would not live in a palace separate from the world. Jesus wanted everyone to come to him unafraid so that he might be their Savior. This message is not just for the rich and the famous. This is a message for the whole world.
We'll be right back.
Welcome back to Larry Prince Live. We're wrapping up on our story of Christmas. My final guest today traveled a very long way to see the baby Jesus, but I think we can all agree that that was a wise decision. Please welcome Cody the Camel.
Thank you, Larry. It's a pleasure, dear boy.
You know my name?
Of course I do, Larry Prince. You're a fine talk show host, and I love your work.
Do you know you're the only animal who got my name right?
Well, you pick up a few things hanging out with wise men.
I guess so.
That's how I came to meet the baby Jesus, you know. My master and his few colleagues spotted his star in the sky, and we all set off on a long journey west.
Did you know you were going to see someone special?
We most certainly did. They don't call them wise men just for being good Monopoly players, you know.
I guess not.
My master and his fellows had read the prophecies of the ancient Israelites, telling of the time and the way in which the new king would be born. As soon as they saw the star, they knew they had to have a look for themselves.
And the star led you to Bethlehem?
No, dear boy. It led us to Jerusalem. That's where the king is, you know. And he was quite puzzled when we asked about the newborn king. Thankfully, the king had some fairly wise fellows of his own, and they opened the book of Micah to say, "You will find him in Bethlehem."
How wise of you to ask directions.
Well, being wise doesn't mean you have all the answers, but it means being smart enough to ask directions.
So you go to Bethlehem and you see the baby Jesus?
Oh, what a little pumpkinhead. He was so cute.
That's what I hear.
He had the cutest dimple.
Heard that too.
My master and his associates brought gifts for him. They brought gold and a spice called frankincense and an oil called myrrh. These were gifts fit for a king, so it was rather strange seeing them in the hands of such poor parents. I could tell they had never seen such things in their lives.
They must have been overwhelmed.
They were, but not near as much as my master. You see, the gifts we brought were nothing compared to the boy. He was the Son of God. He was the Redeemer of the world. He would bring something far more valuable than gold or frankincense or myrrh. He would bring eternal life.
How true.
I still get people today asking me about our journey. What did the star look like? How much gold did you bring? How long did it take to get there? I tell them none of that really matters. We are not the story. The gift in the manger is the real story of Christmas.
Wise words from the wise camel. Thank you, Cody.
My pleasure, Larry.
This has been Larry Prince Live, and now you know the story of the animals in the nativity. So long.
Christmas is a time of giving. It's a time for pitching money into the Salvation Army buckets and shopping for paper angels picked from a tree in the mall. I know you've all been shopping for weeks looking for the perfect gift to give the special people in your life. You want to let them know what the gift, just how special they are, just as the wise men did for Jesus. Just don't lose sight of the baby who is the greatest gift of Christmas.
After Jesus was born in Bethlehem in Judea, during the time of King Herod, Magi from the east came to Jerusalem and asked, "Where is the one who has been born King of the Jews? We saw his star when it rose and have come to worship him." When King Herod heard this, he was disturbed, and all Jerusalem with him. When he called together all the people's chief priests and teachers of the law. He asked them where the Messiah was to be born. In Bethlehem in Judea, they replied, for this is what the prophet has written. But you, Bethlehem, in the land of Judah, are by no means least among the rulers of Judah. For out you will become a ruler who will shepherd my people Israel. Then Herod called the Magi secretly and found out from them exact time the star had appeared. He sent them to Bethlehem and said, go and search carefully for the child. As soon as you find him, report to me, so that I may go and worship him. After they heard the king, they went on their way, and the star they had seen when it rose went ahead of them until it stopped over the place where the child was. When they saw the star, they were overjoyed. On coming to the house, they saw the child with his mother Mary, and they bowed down and worshipped him. Then they opened their treasures and presented him with gifts of gold, frankincense, and myrrh. And having been warned in a dream not to go back to Herod, they returned to their country by another route.
Try all you want, you'll never top the gift that God gave us. Even the wise men with their gold, frankincense, and myrrh couldn't match it. God gave us Jesus. He gave us a Savior who would website. You'll never find a gift that's as wonderful as Jesus.
Thank you. You have heard the tales of Christmas told by those who were there. The donkey, the cow, and the sheep, and the camel have shared their tales from the manger side. Now there's one more tale left to tell, and that tale is yours. Now that you have come to the manger, now that you have heard from those who saw him first, what will you do with Jesus? Will you walk away from the manger and lose yourself in the Christmas lights, or will you begin a new tale by receiving the greatest gift ever given? He's waiting for your answer.
You opened your eyes, did you realize you would be my savior? And the first breath left your lips, did you know that it would change this world forever? And the first time that you opened your eyes, did you realize you would be my savior? And the first breath left your lips, did you know that it would change this world forever? Day that you were born to die, so I could one day pray for you to save my life. Pray for you to save my life. Pray for you to save my
We have a gift from Ms. Sherman from all of the kids to give her for putting on the program.
Aw, thank you. Thank you, Ms. Thank Sherman. You. Appreciate it.
song of old from angel bending near the earth to touch their harps of gold. Peace on the earth, goodwill to men from heaven's all gracious King. The world in solemn stillness laid to hear the angels sing. For lo, the days are hastening on, by prophet bards foretold. When comes round the age of gold, when peace shall over all the earth his ancient splendors flame, and the whole world give back the song which now the angels sing.
Today's benediction comes from 2 Corinthians 13, verse 11. Finally, brothers and sisters, rejoice, strive for full restoration, encourage one another, be of one mind, live in peace, and the God of love and peace will be with you. Have a great week.